Greetings. You know this is for you, brother, and my family there with you. Heavenly Father, I ask you to anoint my words. Anoint your word tonight, Father. Romans 12:2, and be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Romans 10:17. So then, faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Matthew 8:5. And when Jesus was entered into Capernaum, there came unto him a centurion, beseeching him, and saying, Lord, my servant lies at home, sick of the palsy, grievously tormented. And Jesus said unto him, I will come and heal him. The centurion answered and said, Lord, I am not worthy that you should come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my servant will be healed. For I am a man under authority, having soldiers under me. And I say to this man, go, and he goes, and to another, come, and he comes, and to my servant, do this, and he does it. When Jesus heard it, he marveled, and said unto them that followed, Verily I say unto you, I have not found so great faith, no, not in Israel. And I say unto you that many shall come from the east and west, and shall sit down with Abraham and Isaac and Jacob in the kingdom of heaven. And Jesus said unto the centurion, Go thy way, and as you have believed, so be it unto thee. And his servant was healed in the selfsame hour. Verily I say unto you, I have not found so great faith, no, not in Israel. Great faith from a Roman who understood authority. Romans 12:2, and be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. So then faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. And a woman having an issue of blood 12 years, which had spent all her living upon physicians, neither could be healed of any, came behind him and touched the border of his garment, and immediately her issue of blood staunched. That means dried up. And Jesus said, Who touched me? When all denied, Peter and they that were with him said, Master, the multitude throng thee and press against thee. And sayest thou, Who touched me? But Jesus said, Someone did touch me, for I was aware that power had gone out of me. And when the woman saw that she was not hid, she came trembling, and falling down before him, she declared unto him before all the people for what cause she had touched him, and how she was healed immediately. And he said unto her, Daughter, be of good comfort. Thy faith has made thee whole. Go in peace. Press in and touch him in faith. So then faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. And they brought to him a paralytic lying on a bed. Seeing their faith, Jesus said to the paralytic, Take courage, son, your sins are forgiven. And some of the scribes said to themselves, This fellow blasphemes. And Jesus, knowing their thoughts, said, Why are you thinking evil in your hearts? Which is easier to say, Your sins are forgiven, or to say, Get up and walk? But so that you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins, he then said to the paralytic, Get up, pick up your bed, and go home. And he got up and went home. But when the crowd saw this, they were awestruck and glorified God who had given such authority to men. Are your sins forgiven? Which is easier to say? Which is easier to believe? So then faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. You are of God, little children, and have overcome them, because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. There is more value to memorization than just not sinning against God. So then faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Let them not depart from thine eyes, keep them in the midst of thine heart, for they are life unto those that find them, and health to all their flesh. Mark 11:12. On the next day, when they had left Bethany, he became hungry. Seeing at a distance a fig tree in leaf, he went to see if perhaps he would find anything on it. And when he came to it, he found nothing but leaves, for it was not the season for figs. He said unto it, May no one ever eat fruit from you again. And his disciples were listening. Verse 21. Being reminded, Peter said to him, Rabbi, look, the fig tree which you cursed has withered. And Jesus answered, saying unto them, Have faith in God. Truly I say to you, whoever says to this mountain, Be taken up and cast into the sea, and does not doubt in his heart, but believes that what he says is going to happen, it will be granted him. Therefore I say unto you, all things for which you pray and ask, believe that you have received them, and they will be granted you. Sounds like a promise to me. Truly I say to you, whoever says, and does not doubt in his heart, but believes that what he says is going to happen, it will be granted him. Therefore I say unto you, all things for which you pray and ask, believe that you have received them, and they will be granted you. Truly I say to you, whoever says, and does not doubt in his heart, but believes, therefore I say to you, the principle. Truly I say to you, whoever says, and does not doubt in his heart, but believes, the application. Therefore I say unto you, for verily I say unto you that whosoever shall say unto this mountain, Be thou removed and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that those things which he says shall come to pass, he shall have whatsoever he saith. Therefore I say to you, allow that to percolate. For verily I say unto you that whosoever shall say, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that those things which he says shall come to pass, this is a general principle. The example is of the impossible. Say unto this mountain, Be thou removed and be thou cast into the sea. This teaching could apply only to mountains. Until Jesus concludes with whatsoever he says. Therefore I say to you, the principle, the application. Jesus has just told you why he can speak with such authority. He believes in his heart that the things he says will come to pass. Which is easier to say? Your sins are forgiven, or to say, get up and walk. Neither. They are the same. But Texas, don't get someone's hope up. The Lord rebuke you, Satan, you doubting, lying spirit. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, by whom also we have access by faith into this grace wherein we stand, and rejoice in hope of the glory of God. And not only so, but we glory in tribulations also, knowing that tribulation works patience, and patience experience, and experience hope. And hope makes not ashamed, because the love of God is shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost which is given unto us. So then faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. Father, right now I pray in Jesus' name that your Word would bring faith to those that hear it. I pray your Word would be life in their hearts and would be healing in their flesh. I pray your light will fill their very room and your joy would surround them and hug them. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.